Hey guys, welcome back. This is lesson number 3. So I do have a microphone on today. Let me know if you guys hear a difference in quality, and I will try to make sure that I wear it each time for our lessons, okay? So the first thing that we're going to do, I do have an in-depth video on, I guess, maybe 3 or 4 different hand patterns, so you can do this with any hand pattern. We're gonna do this with our basic hand pattern, of course, because it's kind of the most simple and easy for the hand. So the basic hand pattern, we went over this last lesson, looks like this, right? So open 1, 2, sounds like do, re, mi. 2, 3 here, we have fingers squished together and that sounds like jaws. And then we have 3, 4, which sounds like do, re. Okay, and there's a bunch of different intervals that we can do with this. Right now I'm showing you what thirds look like. And then we have fourths. And then we have a fifth. So those are all of the intervals that we can do with this hand pattern. Okay, so we're gonna go through this. So I have my metronome slash tuner over here and it is by Korg. And I have it tuned to 441. And I'm going to be playing with a specific articulation called staccato. It sounds like this. So what you're gonna do, you're gonna put the bow on the string, relax your arm. Remember we talked about the arm looking like this, so not like this, because this is awkward to do. This is a little bit easier, right? So we've got our bow on the string, you move, and you stop. Okay, and if you look at the string, you'll see it vibrate. You probably won't see it here, but it's gonna vibrate, and then stop. Okay, so what we're gonna do is to do this on the A string. Now since I'm on the viola, my A string is this one. But if you're on the violin, your A string is gonna be this one, which is your second one in. Okay, so let's start with getting our left hand set up. So we have 2 points of contact here, right? The neck of the instrument is gonna sit right here. So you can see how it's lining up with these lines on my hands. I'm not sitting it here. I'm not sitting it up here, I'm just kind of lining it up here, and my thumb sits directly across or slightly behind the hand. If it sits in front of your first finger, your hand is going to move up to your thumb, and you're going to find that your intonation gets higher and higher. So let's find that. Okay, now I'm going to put it here, probably not, probably back here, as far back as I can go, and then I'm going to drop first finger into a square. So my finger is in a square position, this not so much, right? This is a square, it's on the tip of the finger, this one's also a square, this one, and this one, okay? And you see how my arm is all the way on the inside here? Not too much, you know, just a comfortable level. You can experiment with it and see how, you know, just popping it back and forth will change the angle, which will also change the intonation just a little bit, okay? So we've got our 2 points, we've got our setup. We're gonna start with open 1, 2, which is do, re, mi, okay? So. And watch that your thumb here, I don't know if you can see my thumb very well, but it's open, right? So it's sitting on the side here. It's not like this, you see how it's closed? It's open like this, so it keeps the hand relaxed. So be just aware of what your thumb is doing when you do this. We're gonna do this 3 times. So this is take 2. And last one. Okay, so now we have jaws. Now I'm also gonna check the octave. So third finger on the A string is a D, and we happen to have an open D string. So if I play open D to third finger D, it's the beginning to Somewhere Over the Rainbow. Right? So if I have, it's not quite right, okay? Also not quite right. And that is kind of your indication that you've lined everything up really well. Also, if you have your tuner handy and you're kind of landing on the green every time, then you should be good. Okay, so we've done jaws. Now we are going to do 3-4 do re. Okay, so we've lined everything up. Now we're gonna start to do some thirds. So a third is just every other note. So if I start with my open string, I'm gonna skip first finger, and then just go to second finger. But I'm gonna put them both down at the same time because I'm training my hand to feel the intervals of whole steps, right? If I just do this, this is kind of unstable and I have no kind of footing, and also I might need to play first finger afterwards, but it's in the air. So we're just trying to make our lives easier. So set them both at the same time for this warm up, okay? Now, what's our song for a major third? Do you remember from the last lesson? It is Vivaldi's Four Seasons. So if I have, doesn't quite sound right, not so much, right? Okay, now we're gonna move on to first finger to third finger, right? We're skipping over the second finger, but I'm putting them both down at the same time. I've kind of glued them together, okay? Now this is a minor third, right? We went over this last time. We have a whole step plus a half step. So this is gonna sound like Iron Man. Right? So two more times. And then we have 2-4, which is what kind of third? This is also a minor third, right? We have the half step from 2-3, and then 3-4, we have a whole step. So another Iron Man. Okay, almost done. We're gonna do the next interval, which is a perfect fourth. So from open to three, this is Here Comes the Bride. We haven't done this one yet, so this is a new one. Right, Here Comes the Bride. Okay, so just open three, and you see how I set all my fingers down, because I'm training my hand to feel distances, right? And just kind of gain some muscle memory. There's one other perfect fourth from first finger to fourth finger, and just look how I set these fingers down, okay? So you see how third finger is actually in the right space there? If I was to play it, it's in tune. So I'm not going to train my hand to do this, because this is kind of in no man's land. This also, this you probably aren't going to do this because this is hard for the hand to do. But try to train your fingers to kind of go to their correct locations. It's going to make your life easier in the long run. So, you can check it. Okay, we have one more interval, which is a perfect fifth. So our new intervals today are perfect fourth, Here Comes the Bride, open three, or 1-4, and a perfect fifth, open four, okay? And our song for this one is the opening to Star Wars. So open four, and you see how I'm setting not all my fingers, I'm kind of just setting 3 and 4 at the same time here. Okay, so that's my warm-up for the basic hand pattern. Now what we're going to do is we're going to play through this hand pattern on every string, okay? So I'm going to give you a little quiz, see what you remember from last time. So let's see, and this is on the violin, okay? You could do this on the viola too, but the viola's not going to have an E string, the violin's not going to have a C string, so we're going to share three of the same strings. But anyway, so what is your first finger on the A string? So it's a B. First finger on the A string is a B. What is your first finger on the D string? It's an E. Yeah, it's an E. What about your third finger on the A string? Third finger on the A string. It's a D. And what about third finger on the D string? Third finger on the D string. It's So that's a G. One more. What is third finger on the A string? I'm sorry, we just did that. Third finger on the E string. Third finger on the E string. So that's an A. Okay. All right, so if you feel comfortable with that, then awesome. If not, go ahead and make sure you keep practicing learning the names of the notes in the basic hand pattern on every string. If you need help with that, you can refer back to the previous video, or I do have an old video on the basic hand pattern, which you can look at. I might need to redo that one. It's kind of weird. Okay, so let's go ahead and play through this basic hand pattern. I'm going to start on the G string. Okay, so for me, this is my bottom string, my second from the bottom string. So, and I'm still playing it staccato. Why staccato, you ask? Because it's easy for you to hear, and it's also easy for the metronome to pick that up too, slash tuner, for the tuner to pick that up. All right, so now let's move on to the D string. And the A string. And for those of you on the violin, here's your E string. Alrighty. So now coming back down, it's a little bit trickier. So what you need to do, let's pretend this is a violin. Now maybe we can do this without fourth finger. Because fourth finger as a beginner is quite hard, but if you're comfortable with it, this is what it would look like. So that would happen kind of quickly, but what I'm doing, I'm setting all of the fingers down, or at least some of them, before I play, so that my fingers are set and they can actually be in tune. So I'm feeling it out really, really quickly, have them sit down. You see how they all go down, so it's not like this. This is unstable, and what are you gonna do with these fingers, you know? So, etc. Now, if you're gonna skip out the fourth finger, it's the same thing. You're gonna set them all. So you see how I set them? One more time. Transition between the string crossings, just try to do things a little faster, but you know, pace yourself, so don't expect to just be able to do that, you know, in one day. Maybe it might take a little time to develop that. Okay, so we've played through the hand pattern warm-up, we've played through all of the strings up and down in the basic hand pattern, and now we are ready to learn some rhythms. Okay, so what I've done here, you can take a screenshot of this. Here we go. These are the rhythms that we're going to learn today. So what I've done is I've numbered how many beats we have here. And underneath that, I've put a quarter note. Now a quarter note is equivalent to one beat, as you can see. Right? Now underneath that, we have eighth notes. So eighth notes are twice as fast. See, there's two of them for only one of these. They're twice as fast as a quarter note. So the way that we're going to count eighth notes is one and, two and, three and, four and, okay? So one and, two and, three and, four and. And you see how every time we say one, two, three, or four, oops, I think I just kind of erased something. I erased my quarter note. So every time we say a number, it lines up with the very first eighth note, okay? So you need to make sure that, you know, your first note is always in line with the beat from the metronome. One and two and three and four and. So for example, this would be wrong. One, two, three, and four and five or something. So you see how the numbers there and the click didn't line up? One and two and three and four and. They're not lining up with the click. One and two and three and four and would line up better. Okay? So we're going to put the metronome on 72 because that's the answer to all questions. What is that? Like 42 from Hitchhiker's Guide? Anyway. So 72 is the number we're going to set ourselves on, and we are going to do four quarter notes, and we're going to do four sets of eighth notes, just like I showed you in that picture. Okay, so we're at 72, here we go. Okay, and for extra brownie points, try counting out loud. One, two, three, four. One and two and. Okay. So if that was easy, we could add another type of rhythm. This will be an extra credit one. Such a teacher. So let me just. Okay. So this is the extra credit rhythm. Now these are called 16th notes. So you can see there's four of them in each beat. So 16th notes are four times as fast as a quarter note, and they're twice as fast as an eighth note. So you have to fit four of them in one beat. So the way that we're gonna count 16th notes, this is the way that everyone counts them. We're gonna count it one, E, and a. One, E, and a. 2E and a, 3E and a, 4E and a. Okay? So let's put our metronome back on 72. 1E and a, 2E and a, 3E and a, 4E and a. It's pretty fast, right? So let's try it. We're going to start with quarter notes and then we'll go directly into 16th notes. Okay? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 1E and a, 2E. Try it again. Three, four, one, two, three, four, one, two, and a, two, and a, three, and a, four, and a. Okay, so that is our rhythm exercise. Last lesson, I think we learned, maybe that was in the very first lesson, we learned triangle, square, extend. So we're already kind of familiar with bow things, and we've been working on sound, maybe. Because of the triangle, square, extend, just making long bows. We did some string crossing exercises a while ago. I think that was in lesson one. So we should be kind of familiar-ish with the bow already. If you're not, I do have some videos on like in-depth sound production and like bowing techniques. So take a look at those if you need extra help with that. Like, you know, more details and the body mechanics and how to hold it and what to do. Take a look at that video. So that's it. We are ready to move on to the Suzuki. You ready? This is our very first song. So this is what I'm using. It's kind of a newer edition. It's called the Revised Edition. And we're going to turn to page 26. If you look in the very, first part of this, you're going to see, you know, pictures for the setup and how to, you know, make sure that you're set up correctly, how to hold the bow, how to stand, and then, you know, different parts of the instrument here. And then in the beginning, they're going to talk to you about, there's a few different languages here, but they're going to talk to you about practicing, maintenance, you know, tuning, all of that type of thing. Is kind of, it's a great book. So, and then we also have some basic rhythms. We've touched on some rhythms, not really these. We are going to touch on. We haven't quite gotten there yet. So you can flip over to page 26 and it looks like this. If you don't have the book, just take a screenshot of this. This is the theme. Okay. Now, just in case you don't have your book with you, I'm going to sit nice and close to you, and we're going to read through these notes here. So, if you remember back to our lesson number 2, we actually went over note reading. So, here we have some space notes, right? Do you remember the acronym for space notes? It's FACE, F-A-C-E, right? So, this note is A, I've labeled it, and I've put a 0 there because it's our open string. Okay, we have an open A. That's what it always looks like. Then we have E, right? Also the open string. Remember, we learned what the open strings look like. Okay. Now this note is, one note above E is A, B, C, D, E, F, right? Now if we look over here in the key signature, this is called the key signature, we have 4 hashtags or 4 sharps. And you might want to go ahead and memorize this acronym for the order of the sharps, right? Because there's 3. We need to know what's the first one, second one, third one. So let's memorize the order. So the acronym that I use is Father Charlie goes down and eats breakfast. Father Charlie goes down and eats breakfast. Father Charlie goes down and eats breakfast. One of my students came up with, and it's so cute because she's very young, and she just innocently said, ferrets curiously go down and eat babies. It was so funny to me, I cracked up. So whatever acronym works for you. So we have F sharp, C sharp, and G sharp. So every time you see an F here, it's actually an F sharp, and that corresponds with the basic hand pattern that we've learned, right? Because on the E string, first finger is an F sharp, which is what we have right here, okay? Then we have an E. No, that's right here. Now what's the difference between this E, this is not filled in, and this, where's E? What's the difference between this E that is filled in and this E that's not filled in? Well, this one's a quarter note, it gets 1 beat, and this one's called a half note, it gets 2 beats. So, da, 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 you're gonna hold that for 2 beats. Okay, fortunately, most of us know Twinkle Twinkle Little Star, so it shouldn't be a problem. All right, now what's this one? This is a line note. Remember, every good boy does fine. Or you can just think this is, well, this is E, this is one note below E, so it's a D. It's your third finger on the A string. Then we have C sharp. Father Charlie goes down and eats breakfast. Father Charlie, C sharp. So we have a C sharp here. And that also corresponds with our basic hand pattern. And then we have B, right? Remember my trick? The line notes are either first finger or third finger. And the space notes are either your open second or fourth finger, right? So here's our line note. And this actually happens to be very close to A, right? So if you remember what the open strings look like, you should be able to kind of figure this out pretty quickly, right? So this line and this line are exactly the same. Let's go ahead and just quickly look through the second line. So I'm gonna tell you the names of these notes here, just to make sure you got it. So we have E, D, C sharp, B, and this is called a half note, right? Then we have the same thing again, so E, D, C sharp, B. And then third line is the same as the first line. Okay, so what we're gonna do is get ourselves set up. So find your 2 points. Let me turn you this way. So find your 2 points, right? We're gonna sit here or here? Here, drop your squares. And if you want, you can go ahead and play Do Re Mi. Now this is gonna be on the violin, not the viola, at least that's what we just worked on. So my fingering is gonna look a little different. So what I'll do is, let's pretend this is the violin for a moment, that this is the A string and this is the E string, so you can see what your fingers are gonna look like. And then I'll play it up here so that if you wanna play along with me, you know what it sounds like. Okay, so This is what it looks like on the violin. Ready? For you, let's take a look at measure three. So we're in the first line and count over to measure three. It starts on a D. Now we're transitioning from your open E to D. So when we're playing our open string, should our fingers be here? And then at the last moment, move over to the A string? Probably not. It's kind of harder to do this. You gotta move a big distance. So use the open string as an opportunity to get yourself kind of hovering and set up over the A string, because that's where you're going next. And you should be good if you do that. Okay? Any other thoughts? Oh. Also, I was playing this in the lower half of the bow. Now, you don't have to do that. You can play this in the upper half of the bow. You could play this in the middle of the bow. But you could use the entire bow if you want. You just want it to sound really nice. And you can also pay attention to, you know, playing closer to the bridge or playing closer to the fingerboard, experimenting with the sound, see what that does. Any idea what playing close to the bridge does to the sound? Makes it a little bit brighter, a little bit harsher sometimes. When you play close to the bridge, I'm sorry, when you play close to the fingerboard. And that's, you know, with a similar weight on the bow. It's just differences in the contact point. So it's naturally a bit softer there. So experiment with it. Paint with your bow, I almost said paintbrush. Paint with your bow and see what that does to the sound. Okay, so let me play it up here in fourth position, and you can play along with me if you want. Okay, so. Practicing with that. I think this is probably long enough, so next time we will go over the variations. That one's going to be kind of a long lesson. We will do maybe a little test on ear intervals and see how our ear is hearing them. I might have you play some of them for me just to test and see if you understand how to play them. And we probably will go over, you know, lining up these rhythms with the metronome, because then you can just really feel how they all line up together. We'll go over counting out loud, and that's it. Now, typically, in an actual live lesson, it would be longer. So we would be going over some technical things as well. So I would be showing you, you know, some basic hand pattern scale routines. Now, I do have scale routine videos that you can look at. So that involves with like slurring two or three or four up to eight notes at a time with a metronome. Then we'll add some rhythms, and then we'll work on speed. So that might be a little bit kind of advanced at the moment, but everyone is different. Some people can just pick that up right away. So if you want more of a challenge, you could check out my videos on scale routines and just apply that to the basic hand pattern, because we haven't learned a scale yet. We will probably touch on that at some point, though, if you want to just wait. So I'll see you next time. I hope you guys are enjoying this. I really love doing these, actually. I think it's very fun. If you have also any requests, I was thinking of maybe teaching you some fiddle songs. I learned a lot of fiddle music when I was younger, and it's just so much fun to play. So anyways, I'll see you guys very soon. Bye.